Hi guys and welcome back in MedicalScribe. This video is the third video in the Introduction to Anatomy series. And today we will talk about the surface anatomy. In order to know the meaning of the surface anatomy, we should rememorize what we said in the previous video, which is the regional anatomy study the human body organization in layers manner. That means we will begin from the superficial structures, descending down to the deep structures. Or, we will begin by the skin, descending down to the subcutaneous tissue, then to the deep fascia, which envelope the muscles, bones, and internal organs. Okay? Good. So, there are some of these deep structures are obvious, and we can palpate them through the skin. And also, we can study them and imagine what we will find under the skin by the surface anatomy. So, the surface anatomy is to study, knowing, and imagine what is found under the skin in a specific region. And what is the structures that we can palpate through the skin in the person, which is either at rest or in action. Alright, by studying the surface anatomy, we have two main goals we want to achieve. One is a theoretical, and the other is a practical or a clinical. Regarding the theoretical goal, is to imagine, knowing, and palpating the structures that found it under the skin, which means that our eyes will become like the X-ray machine that check a bag contents, for example. So, we will can visualize the structures that found under the skin. While the practical or the clinical goal is to distinguish if there is any abnormality while we palpating the regions, because we already know what is here in the normal state, so if there is any abnormality, we can detect it. But in order to achieve these two goals, we must understand the anatomy of these deep structures firstly. So, when we come to imagine or palpate the skin, we will be oriented of what we need to find here in this place through correlating the anatomical information with what we are doing here. And now, I will give you two examples to clarify the importance of the surface anatomy in our real life. Imagine you are in the emergency department when someone is stabbed by a knife in his upper right abdomen. Present to you. So if you understand the surface anatomy well, you will imagine which structures may be damaged due to the stab. And this is a very critical issue in order to assess the severity of this case and how you will manage him then. The second example is in the physical examination. Is when you come up to inspect the region, you have to palpate it. So, when you palpate it, you will know if there is any fractures in the bone or if there is any enlargement in an organ, and also we can palpate the radial pulse in the wrist joint. So these and others are the clinical applications of the surface anatomy, and it's very important things in our practical life. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video, and goodbye.